In. Well, welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We're here 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create new agreements based on respect and love. Take the responsibility to make new agreements with those you love. And if an agreement doesn't work, change the agreement, create a new one, and use your imagination to explore all the possibilities. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 32, NASDAQ off 48, S&P's down 12. Bottom line, you really had a sideways market. That being said, you get slightly lower. Market tried to go higher. Couldn't handle price. That's the type of market we get right now. It's having a hard time holding price, folks. The composite, NASDAQ composite was down 0.6%. S&Ps were down 0.4%. And you had the Dow Industrials down 0.1%. Gold contract down $6.50, trading at $13.08 an ounce. You had the silver contract down 15 cents, $15.27 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 58 cents. $59.36 a barrel. Now, we had the oil numbers out this morning. Bottom line is that oil's having a really tough time at this $60 level. What we did out here today, you got into it, back down off it, and where this is coming from, folks, it's pretty wild. Oil went down $5 on November 13th. That's the supply line, and it's a monster. So who's ever up here at the $60, more than likely, what you're basically laying out here, more than likely what you're seeing is that that's probably a producer. Because what we did out here, not that the oil numbers, they came in with a slight build this morning. But bottom line is that they just couldn't handle price. Notes and bonds, bottom line, higher price, lower yield. And this is pretty intense, folks, because this is a very fast move. We're at 2.379 right now. Now, just to give you an idea, this is what's just absolutely amazing. I mean, I've been into bonds since 1980, but this move here is extraordinary. So picture this. Hey, I got to bring this up on the side so you can see this. We are almost down, folks, a full point in the 10-year note within 12 months. That's amazing. 2.379 is what we're trading at right now. 3.2 was the high for the year. Now, just so you can understand what that's going to do, if we go take a look at this and we put the 30 up, what you're going to see, because this is going right along the whole curve, the 30 right now is at 2.8 and the high was 3.4. So you can see you're off 0.6%. Well, what that's going to do, of course, to the mortgage market is that what you have inside that mortgage market is that you're going to be basically pushing out 3.65, 3.75 mortgages. Lots of traction for these builders. And if you take a look at Lennar came out with the numbers last night. Bottom line, you get a monster ABC structure on the way up. Up $1.96 today. It blew away a B point. We pulled this up. And where do you see this thing, man? This is just, and if we take a look at this, what I want to show you is that all of the, Lennar actually did is came back to strength. Last high in Lennar was on January of 2018. That was at $72. It comes down to 37. Now, you got to remember, it started at $3.40. Well, as it come down, it was going right into strength at 171 million shares, and it only did 80. Takes off again topside, has the volume behind the move. You got a nice ABC structure up. Your B point on this is $50.50. Your A is 37, so you get 13 bucks. Your C is 44, so you're talking 60 bucks. 57. Talking 57 bucks. And 57 bucks is going to bring you over the consolidation that was placed out here in between May and September before it had the downdraft. So you get lots of moving pieces out here with lower interest rates coming at us. Notes, so 10-year note up 6 ticks, 124.19. 30-year bond up 24, trading at a price point of 149.27. And then what we have a good old King Dollar. King Dollar out here, up 185 ticks. What King Dollar did not do out here today is that it couldn't even get to its February swing high. So it looks to me like King Dollar is still going to go have movement sideways to lower. What you can keep your eye on basically right now and all night long, it's going to be the British pound, folks. The British pound looks to me like it's going to go after its swing high. The swing high that we're talking about inside the British pound is a price point of 133.81. Now, I understand that no one's trading the British pound. The reason you want to understand what the British pound's doing, however, it's going to affect our dollar. It'll pull our dollar back lower. And what that's all about is that we have Theresa May out here. She promised her colleagues inside the Conservative Party that if they vote for her deal, the Brexit deal, that she will resign. And that includes she brought Boris Johnson into it. She brought Ian Smith into it. And those two have quite a bit of pull. And they flat out said they're going to back down and they're going to support the divorce agreement. And that's going to, we'll see whether that can put her over the top. She'll get over the top, but in the aspect of getting over the top, she's going to basically not be the prime minister anymore. So that's going to be pretty wild watching how that does shake out. But that's going to move that British pound. What we haven't seen yet is that the euro is still at the lower end of the consolidation it's been in. You know, we'll see whether it can basically take off topside once again. The euro's trading 124, 112 rather, 112.48. And this is right next to breaking down again, because 112.17 is a breakdown. And that could be pretty intense, man. You know, I don't see it happening right now because of the fact that what we very well are going to have is that we're going to have news on this ASAP. And, of course, the news on this ASAP has to do with the aspect of them doing the Brexit. And what it looks like when you're looking at that pound is that the market is basically happy that there's going to be some kind of a deal. And the market, the British pound all along actually has looked that it is, number one, going topside, wants to stay topside, and all of the above. Dow Industrials right now, they traded down 32. You had the NASDAQ off 48. S&P's down 12 and a half. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.